Hello friends, welcome to Aquilmech Live. I'm Kanchan Varma and today we are discussing about a publication which started by Vardharaja Iyengar at Mysore in 1970. Now Sudharma is the first oldest Sanskrit newspaper publication. And to discuss about this publication and Sanskrit language, we have a guest. We'll come to know her ideas and the worries about the newspaper and the Sanskrit language. What she thinks, how we can handle the issue of learning Sanskrit. So stick around to this episode till the end. You will get more information about Sudharma and her ideas about Sanskrit learning. Welcome back, and today we have a very interesting personality with us and we'll be discussing something very interesting with her. So we have Ritu Gupta, who is a CEO of Four Seasons, and we'll be discussing about a Sanskrit paper which was published, which is actually published in Mysore. So before that, I would like to welcome her and ask her, how is she today?
Thank you, Kanchan. Thank you for inviting me to the show. And I'm feeling very fine, absolutely happy. And since I'm talking to you, I feel very energetic also.
Well, wonderful. And actually, this idea to talk about this paper came a few days back when I searched the syllabus of my children and they have introduced a language, Sanskrit. And you know, Sanskrit is quite an ancient language, and I think everybody should learn, and we have also learned in our school, but somehow in all this hustle and bustle of life, we couldn't continue with this language. So what is your idea about this particular language?
Kanchan, Sanskrit, I feel very happy that I belong to the country where Sanskrit was originated, and our Vedas, especially the Vedas of Hinduism, of course Vedas are there only in Hinduism, they are all written, all the religious books have been written in Sanskrit. And as the myth is about Sanskrit, that it's a very tough language, but you know, it's not really very difficult to learn Sanskrit. It's a very beautiful, beautiful sounding, very poetic, with beautiful phonetic sounds. The language is very good. And on the other hand, I personally feel that people should know Sanskrit. It's the most ancient language. Even in Chinese language, some words are from Sanskrit. So it's a very beautiful language, and I feel very proud that I belong to the country, which is the land of Sanskrit.
Well, as I just want to tell you that today we'll be discussing about this paper, Sudharma, which is published from Mysore. So do you have an idea what kind of paper it is, and would like to talk about this? Because I really feel very interesting, though it was started publishing in 1970, I guess. Though after many newspapers have already started publishing in Sanskrit. But what is this particular about this particular publication in Sanskrit?
Yeah, Sudharma, which is a Sanskrit paper, and it started its publication in 1970. And I believe some time back, when there was a research which was conducted, and it says that still they have published till date. Publish the paper, 3,500 circulation is always taking place. And this is published from a place called Mysore, which is in South India. So this is very surprising. But you know, another fact is this, that in most of the South Indian languages, like, you know, in Kannad and in other language, Tamil also, there are some words of Sanskrit. So I still feel that the people down south in India, they really care for this language, and there are certain communities there who really want to read the news, the current happenings and other related issues of international and national value in Sanskrit. And I feel that every child, every student must be asked to read Sanskrit language, because at the end of the day, Sanskrit is the mother of many languages. So people should read Sanskrit, and it's a very good effort that the newspaper is being published in Sanskrit.
Well, as far as the history of Sanskrit, which I've read, that this newspaper started by a scholar in Mysore, and the main aim is, as you mentioned, is to safeguard this particular ancient language, and that is why this is a two-folded newspaper. But you know, there are many good people, good scholars, and even politician. If you remember Sushma Swaraj, she used to speak.
Yes,
she has a very profound knowledge and speaking. She used to speak very fine Sanskrit language. Now, I would like to really add that Sanskrit is a very good language, because any language, there is no discrimination. We can learn any language. But I think we should give more stress of learning Sanskrit in the school, because firstly, it is a traditional language, because many mantras, as you mentioned, and even the pujas and many ceremonies are done by Sanskrit, reciting of Sanskrit language. Are you accustomed? Do you have understanding of any of these ritual where we use Sanskrit as a language?
Well, yes, there are many rituals where we use Sanskrit as a language. I think most of the rituals, if you really conduct the ritual in a traditional Hindu manner, Sanatani manner, then you conduct the rituals actually in Sanskrit. And even I studied Sanskrit in my school till 8th standard, 8th grade. But somehow then, you know, I just could not carry forward, and it was not compulsory. In my school, it was compulsory till 8th standard in CBSE. But then somehow I retrieved back from Sanskrit. But I still feel that it is one language which makes your grammar very strong, your pronunciation very strong, and it also lets you get closer to your culture. So Sanskrit, I believe, yes, it's very important. And kids nowadays, they should be again taken close to Sanskrit language. Because, you know, even in scientific facts, where in science also, let's say in physics and chemistry also, they talk about certain things in Sanskrit. So Sanskrit and science has a very strong connection.
You see, what I feel is that we have newspapers in English, we have newspaper in Hindi, we have our regional newspaper also coming out. Like we have a newspaper when you go down south in Tamil, in Telugu. Yeah. But somehow we are ignoring this language, and I think there should be community effort to help people to understand this language, and not only it improves the language capability, communication skill in other language for the children, but you know, few aspects of computer is also based on Sanskrit. So I feel
yes, it's
quite an important language, and we should give more courage and effort for people to accept this. What do you feel about it?
Yes, I feel that people should be more receptive towards Sanskrit, and parents should make it a joint effort that parents and kids, they should try to speak, let's say for 10 minutes or 15 minutes over dinner time, they should try to speak in Sanskrit. And you know, while I was talking to you, I just remembered one thing which I read in newspaper some time back during this lockdown, that there is one particular village in down south where people, they speak only in Sanskrit language. Now, how beautiful this is. How nice. People, they really value for their culture, and they want to retrieve the culture. They want their culture to be there. And so they speak in Sanskrit. They let their kids speak in Sanskrit. So everything officially is done in Sanskrit out there. Even the boards outside the shop, outside the post office, is all written in Sanskrit. I think this is very beautiful, and we should all make an effort. At least an awareness should be created about Sanskrit. There should be some kind of activities which should take place in Sanskrit in school. You know, there are various workshops, various group activities which are taking place in school, even online also, so that kids, they try respecting the language, they try understanding the value, importance of Sanskrit.
Well, yes, because you know, no language is inferior, because these are great, great inventions actually by our ancestors. So every person should be more than interested to learn any language which comes in front of him. But I think Sanskrit learning is something which will be good for everybody in the country. Now as we were discussing, there's the newspaper which is the oldest newspaper, Sudharma, which was started by Vardharaja Iyengar. I think this whatever legacy he has left, I think maybe in community wise or somehow we should help and continue maybe helping and conserving this newspaper. I think that's very, very important. And so any last thoughts you want to share with our viewers?
Like you said, any language is good, and learning of any language adds on to your personality. I 101% agree with this. And as to conserving the newspaper Sudharma, which is a legacy left by the owner, so I think we should make an effort to write some small articles for the newspaper. Whatever we observe, we can write some stories in the newspaper. And you know, the kids, they should be made to write in Sanskrit. So this is how you can make a newspaper go on and on. There should be some contribution from every person in the society for the newspaper. So you know, this improves your language also, this improves your thought process also, and at the same time you do some kind of research. If you want to write on food, if you want to write on travel, you definitely make some research so that you write a very beautiful article. And why not write an article in Sanskrit language? So I believe that each one of us should at least give some time from our daily routine life, from a busy life, to a language, Sanskrit. At least 10 minutes or 15 minutes a day we can give to the language. So we learn also.
Yeah, definitely. But I also want to add one thing, that Sudharma is not having any marketing department. So I think so this is something which I came to know. So I think that people should promote this, and people should think about, like we think about other aspects of life, that this is a very, very kind of good work which is being done from the museum. We should think and do a community effort to enhance.
Not the paper,
yes, but then language and people who are related with this publication. As usual, you want to add something?
Yes, like you said, that you know, we people, we as community, we definitely enhance certain ideas, certain issues. Like we have enhanced the thought about using toilet, washing the hands, about Swachh Bharat campaign. So we should also help this newspaper, because since it does not have a marketing department, we ourselves can do something so that the newspaper remains alive. You know, because I read that the publication, the circulation of the newspaper was 3,500. So it's not a very big circulation. So, you know, the schools, the college community, the universities, they can ask their students to buy the newspaper every month or write something for the newspaper. This way, the newspaper will go on. And, you know, in public libraries, in RWAs, people, they can get the copy of the newspaper, and so that the circulation goes on and on. It's important.
Yes, and you know, this is Sudharma is the one of the oldest Sanskrit publication in India, and I think it has to be a voluntary. We can't voluntary effort by the people. So forward, I think people will think about it and do something and learn Sanskrit. So as usual, Ritu, it is so wonderful to talk to you today. We'll meet again with some other interesting topic. Till then, bye-bye.
Thank you, Kanchan. Thank you. It's so nice to talk to you. Thank you.